Hello friends, today we are going to introduce you the powerful SMD rework station model HAS60W sold by India Enterprises. It's a very powerful hottest station of 1000 watt and it can be used for all sizes of SMD components, starting from chip components to large size ICs. So let's begin and we'll show you how it is connected to the main power with the help of the 3-pin plug. However, we can use external crook cord. We can insert this banana plug into the socket and then we can connect this crocodile clip to the external grounding if it is required. The next step is how to increase or decrease the temperature. First, we need to lift the iron from the support rack, because whenever we do this, the hot air is activated and the temperature starts increasing, and whenever we keep it back on the support rack, it will go into the sleep mode and it will be automatically switched off. So this is very useful. Now we will show you the maximum and minimum temperature reading. It can go up to 500 degrees centigrade, and on the bottom side it can go up to 100 degrees centigrade. Similarly, this with the help of these push buttons, we can increase or decrease the hot air flow. The maximum hot air flow is 120 liter per minute, and if you keep pressing this down button, then we can see that the minimum hot air flow is 1 liter per minute. There are three different channels available on the front panel, and each channel denotes a set temperature and hot air flow. Channel 2 is 300 selected 300 and hot air flow of 120 liter. Similarly, for channel 3, 400 degree is the temperature and 120 liter is the hot air flow, but according to our own choice we can adjust this reading, and we can choose our own favorite temperature or hot air flow. Suppose if we want to alter the use a different reading for channel 1, we can do that. All we need to do this by pressing the up or down button, select this suitable temperature, and similarly select the hot air flow according to our own choice and press this channel 1 button for few seconds, and the reading we have chosen is automatically saved at channel 1. Similarly, we can do the same procedure for channel 1 or channel 3, so channel 2 or channel 3 if it is required. Different type of hot air nozzles are provided, like this 4 side heating nozzle for large size ICs, universal round nozzles, and this pickup tool is also provided along with this unit. With the help of this pickup tool, we can remove SMD components by inserting this tool beneath the SMD component and give hot air from the top, and with the help of this combination we can easily remove hot air. With the help of this combination we can easily remove SMD ICs. We will show you how to use these nozzles. This is very easy to insert in this hot air iron. We can simply push it inside, and for removing we can use this slot for removing the hot air nozzles. This hot air rework station is also equipped with a locking feature, by the help of which we can lock this station at a certain temperature and hot air flow. So we will show you how to activate this feature. First, we need to switch the unit off and press the channel 2 key and switch the unit on. We will encounter C, then we will see that this blank is flashing on the display. All we need to do is to use this up temperature or down temperature key to select favorite password. Like if we want to use 005 as our password, we need to select this 0 first, then move to next step we need to press this up slide here button, then again 0, again this up button and select 5, then press channel 2 once again and repeat the same process. And then press channel 2. Now the password has been saved. The password we selected was 005, so the same password has been saved. And once we switch the unit off and then switch it on, we can see that we cannot change the temperature. Temperature has been logged, and similarly we cannot change the hot air flow. So the temperature and hot air flow has been locked at certain level, and without changing the password or without inputting the password, we cannot change the temperature or hot air reading. The this hot air rework station is also featuring a calibration function. By using it, we can periodically calibrate this unit to maintain the quality standards and for a uniform reworking. We will show you how to calibrate this unit. First, we need to just measure the temperature of this hot air iron with the help of an external calibrator, and if any deviation is observed, then we can just change the temperature setting inside this unit. In the on state, when the hot air iron is on and the unit is in unlocked state, all we need to do is to press channel 1 and channel 3 simultaneously for 15 seconds. After 15 seconds, it will enter into the calibration mode, and we can just with the help of this temperature key, up down key, and this to move the cursor further, we can use this hot air key, and we can just enter the value which we have observed on the external calibrator. And this is how the calibration is done. And after, once we enter the value, the actual value which we have observed, then again press the channel 2 button to save the temperature reading, the actual temperature reading. So this is how the unit is calibrated. So that's all we have right now. Thanks for watching.